November 10th, 1757. A.M. The waters of the deluge had subsided, and the earth became dry on the 27th of the Tuti month, corresponding with this date November 10th. 570. Birthday of Mahomet, as settled by the Benedictines by other authority, April 21st, 571. 1202. Siege of Jadera, now Zara, by the Venitian crusaders. It was a Roman city, colonized by Augustus. 1270. Edward I joined the African crusade before Tunis, a few weeks after the death of Louis, in his tent. 1444. Battle of Varna, between the Turks under Amurath, and the Christians under Ladislaus of Hungary, in which the latter were defeated, and Ladislaus in 10,000 slain. 1549. Paul III Alexander Farnese, Pope, died. It was with him that Henry VIII came to a rupture, which severed the Church of England from that of Rome. 1558. Last auto da fe in the reign of Queen Mary of England. It is supposed that in about 3 years 280 persons perished at the stake. 1567. Anne de Montmorency, Marshal of France, killed at the Battle of St. Denis, after performing prodigies of valor. He commanded at many memorable battles. 1624. Henry Wriothesley, Earl of Southampton, one of the most steady patrons of men of learning, died at Bergen-op-Zoom, in Holland. 1683. John Collins, an eminent English mathematician, died, the intimate correspondent of the learned men of his times. 1715. Godfrey Olerius, a learned German divine and historian, died. 1721. John Mapletoft, an eminent English physician and divine, died, aged 91. 1722. The Royal Anne Galley, cast away near Lizard Point, and Lord Belhaven, governor of Barbados, with other passengers and ship's crew, perished. Two sailors only saved. 1735. Thomas Dean, of Malden, a writer and printer, died in Kent, aged 102. 1750. Edward Bright, an English grocer, died, aged 29. His height was 5 feet 10 inches, his bulk round the body, 6 feet 11 inches, and his weight, 537 pounds. 1758. The oldest lion in the Tower of London died, said to be 68 years old. It had been presented to James II by one of the Barbary states. 1769. Captain Hollymore died at Vauxhall, England. His mother had prepossessed him when a child, that he should die on the 10th of November, 1769, and in consequence of that prepossession, he made his will, and gave orders about his funeral, and though seemingly in perfect health when he went to bed, was found dead next morning, without the least sign of violence of any kind. 1781. Negapatam, in the East Indies, surrendered by the Dutch to the British, with 8,000 prisoners. 1794. The French Convention closed the Hall of the Jacobins, and banished the society. They also banished the emigrants forever from France, and confiscated their estates. 1795. The schooner Whitefish arrived at Philadelphia, from Presque Isle, on Lake Erie. The Whitefish was 17.5 feet keel, and 5 feet 7 inches beam, and performed her remarkable voyage in 7 weeks, passing the Falls of Niagara 10 miles by land, and proceeding by Lake Ontario, the Oswego River, Lake Oneida, Wood Creek, the Mohawk and Hudson Rivers, to her place of destination, 947 miles. The vessel was built and navigated by two young men, who made their unique voyage without chart or compass. 1797. Catherine II, of Russia, died. She seized her husband and probably had him murdered, by which she became sole mistress of the throne. She possessed many bad qualities, mixed with some good ones. 1797. Frederick William II, of Prussia, died. 1802. An island in latitude 5 degrees 49 N, longitude 162 degrees 23 W, from London, discovered by Captain Soule, of the Palmyra, of Providence, Rhode Island, which he called Palmyra Island. 1808. Guy Carleton, a distinguished British officer in America, and governor of Canada, died. His great exertions saved Canada, when besieged by the Americans, under Montgomery and Arnold. 1812. United States schooner Growler, Lieutenant Mix, having under convoy a British prize schooner, by a masterly maneuver saved his prize and captured another British schooner, under convoy of two armed ships, on Lake Ontario. The schooner had $12,000 on board, and the private property and baggage of General Brock. 1813. The British under Lord Wellington attacked the French position at Anahu, in Spain, and took 51 cannon and 1,400 prisoners. Of the loss of the Spanish, French loss, 3,000. 1825. Com. McDonough, who commanded the fleet at Plattsburgh in 1814, died of consumption at Middletown, Connecticut. 1832. John Gaspard Spurzheim, the celebrated German phrenologist, died. He came to America in the same year of his death, after having traveled through several countries on the continent, for the purpose of propagating the science, and making investigations. 1834. Earl Spencer, an English statesman, died. He was much respected for his talents and virtues, and possessed the finest private library in Europe. 1835. Andrew Ljungstedt died, a Swedish author of great learning, who resided at Macau, in China, 40 years, and wrote a history of the Portuguese settlements in China. 1837. Albert Pauling died, age 88, an officer in the Revolutionary Army, and engaged in several battles. He was the first sheriff of Rensselaer County, and first mayor of Troy. 1838. Santa Cruz, president of Bolivia, and protector of Peru, entered Lima at the head of a large army, Gomara, with the Chilean army, having evacuated it. 1843. John Trumbull, a celebrated American painter, and aide to General Washington during the War of the Revolution, died in New York, age 87, New Haven, where 55 of his paintings are preserved in the college. His chef d'oeuvre is the great painting of the signers of the Declaration of Independence. 1851. William G. Belknap, an officer of the United States Army, died, aged 56. He distinguished himself at Buena Vista. 1852. The punishment of death re-established in Tuscany, for treason, crimes against religion, murder, and robbery with violence. 1852. A treaty was ratified between the courts of Vienna and Rome, stipulating that the latter should support in the territories of the Pope, 12,000 infantry and 1,400 cavalry, for whom $18,000 per month was to be paid by the papal government. 1852. Gideon Algernon Mantell, an eminent English geologist, died in London, aged 62. 1853. Thomas M. Nelson, an officer in the War of 1812, died at Columbus, Georgia, aged 71. 1853. Maria, Queen of Portugal, died in childbed. She was buried on the 19th with great solemnity and demonstrations of public regret.